What is up, beautiful people of YouTube? My name is Yuritastic with a very special episode. I am going to be showing you today how to install LSPDFR 0.4 that just came out. Well, came out yesterday. I'm doing an episode today. A lot of people gave you the showcase. I was planning on doing a showcase episode, but all my close friends, basically from Not AJ, but Gaming, Yo Adrian, everybody basically that I know, and even the big time LSPDFR YouTubers have already done a showcase of how to, or showcase of what's going on with LSPDFR 0.4. So today I wanted to give you kind of a detailed tutorial on how to install the game, all right? Or not the game, the mod. Now keep in mind, there's a few things. That's why it's called a detailed installation. You need to listen to me before you do something, and then you come back in the comment section, say it didn't work, la 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 la. There's a few things, all right? So let's click here and let me show you the first thing. If you are installing LSPDFR and a clean GTA 5 version, you don't need to worry about anything I'm mentioning at all. Now, contrary to what they're saying, the reason they say they strongly recommend that you do it in a clean GTA 5 version, but it's not necessary. So if you already have your plugins, your visual mods, all this stuff, and you don't want to, or your cars, and you don't want to take that out, you can keep that in. So the first thing you need to understand before we even touch the download this file, because installing LSPDFR 0.4 is literally a work of 30 seconds. You don't need to worry about that. What you need to worry about is this. What I recommend you do entirely is coming over here, copying your GTA 5 completely and pasting it somewhere else on your hard drive. Why is that? The reason you do that, because I believe 0.3 is not going to be available for download or redistribution anytime soon. And don't forget, 0.4 is great, it's amazing, but you only get the calls that come with it, which is basically a pursuit and a robbery right now. So if you want to play 0.3 with all the callouts, all the plugins that are optimized for 0.3, you need to have that folder aside so you can just switch them in and out. So sorry, the first step I would do is copy paste GTA 5, paste it somewhere else in your hard drive. That's gonna take forever. I'm not gonna do it, but I already did it because it's 133 gigabytes. It's gonna take about 30, 40 minutes, maybe 25 if your computer is excellent. So that's the first thing. The second thing, like I told you, you go in plugins, LSPDFR, boom, delete that. The third thing, which is optional, you can try to do it and see if it works for you, or you can just take it off the bat. When I was watching Epic Gaming streaming, and he was doing it literally like minutes after LSPDFR came out, he kept having texture loss because he had visual mods in his mods folder. If you have a mods folder, what you need to do, which is again is optional, you can keep it in there and try it out. If it doesn't work, you can come back and delete it. For me, it wasn't an issue, and I put it back in. It wasn't an issue. What you need to do is delete the mods folder, all right, and then go create another mods folder. Call it mods, not one. I'm just calling it mods one because I already have mods. And copy paste update 64 and in there. So you copy paste this, you go in the mods folder, you paste them in there, blah blah blah, bada bing bada boom. I'm not gonna go in that again because that takes forever. So that's the third thing. So let's recap real quick, because like I told you, the installation process of 0.4 is not that complicated. First step, come to Steam, copy paste your GTA 5, put it somewhere else on your hard drive. This way you still have access to 0.3. this way you can still have all the LSPDFR callouts and plugins. Second step, you come in LSPDFR, the main folder, you go in plugins, you will have something. Again, I'll put it for the sake of this tutorial. You should have a folder, it's called LSPDFR, and it should have the plugins in it. Delete that entirely because that's not going to do you good. The third thing, which is optional, is delete the mods folder and then create another mods folder. Call it mods, just mods, and copy paste update and x64 into that mods folder. This way, all your visual stuff like NVR, maybe your custom visual settings, all of them can be deleted. You will have, unfortunately, stock GTA graphics. You will have stock GTA sirens, but that's not gonna crash your game at least. Now we're done with all these steps before that. Now again, this is a detailed tutorial. You go and download this, which I already did, but one thing I wanna show you, you don't need to do anything, it's automatic. Don't download the manual, bro. Download the LSPDFR 0.4 setup.zip, the second one. And once it comes here, you're gonna extract it, obviously, in whatever you wanna extract it. And if you installed LSPDFR 0.3, this is the same thing. You just click on it twice. It's gonna be automatic, bada bing, bada boom. You got LSPDFR 0.4, okay? Same exact installation process. However, just because you're not installing on a clean GTA vanilla version, that's why you need to take these three steps, okay? I'm about to hop in the game and show you guys. Once again, I'm not gonna be doing a complete showcase because we're you know, a lot of people have already done that. Maybe once things have come up, or maybe if I have enough comments from you guys in the comment section below, that hey, I want to see you do it, Juratastic. I don't care about them other guys, even though they're all great, but I want to see you do it. I want to see my boy Juratastic do it. Then I'll do it if there's enough demand for it. But as of right now, I'm not planning on it. So let's run LSPDFR, and I'll get back to you once we get in the game so I can show you that install correctly. So if you're new to the channel, make sure you check out my LSPDFR episodes. I can always use LSPDFR fans on this channel, so I appreciate you if you hit the subscribe button and become part of the J Army. Now let's just talk briefly while this loads, guys. Should you upload or should you update to LSPDFR 0.4? If you're an avid LSPDFR player and you want all the plugins, all the bells and whistles, as of right now, I would say hang on. Unless you have two copies of GTA 5, like I showed you, just paste it somewhere else on a hard drive. That's great. But besides that, I would say hang on. Due to the reason that no plugin is really optimized except Albo's as of the time of this recording. Now, you could keep an eye out on the LSPDFR website and make sure that, you know, that the plugins and the callouts, etc., so on and so forth, get updated. So should you update right this minute with everybody else? I would say hang on. There's still a lot of bugs going on with 0.4. It's literally a fresh mod that they've been working on for years. So here we are, it has been loaded. And what's nice about it, check this out. Again, this is not a showcase, but I'm just showing you briefly what's going on. Check this out. This is awesome that you just literally jump in. And by the way, the loading screen never used to take this long in 0.3. Some people are reporting frame drops, like major frame drops. Like, we're still on a loading screen. So I haven't really noticed that. Look at that. It comes down and then you actually spawn in with your uniform. Look at that. Like, kind of like GTA 5 style, right? And isn't that cool? You get back in your car and I think you already spawn on duty, I believe. And I think there's an option to do that or not. So there's a few things, but here you are. I mean, that's what's cool about it. Like, as you can see, I'm a National Vision Remastered still. And I didn't really have to take it out, even though I did delete the mods folder. I put it back in and it worked just fine for me. Other people didn't. But that's what's cool about it. Obviously, I still have the in-game cards because I deleted my mods folder. I don't have any special cards, anything like that. But that's it, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, there's a few things like police backup menu, officer juratastic menu, and even if you come here in the main menu for Grand Theft Auto, you come in here and you go to key bindings, and it even shows you all the key bindings for LSPDFR, which is really, really nice. I mean, that's really cool. So besides that, ladies and gentlemen, like I said, should you update or not? Oh, one more thing, callouts. I'm hoping other callouts get I guess developer callouts that are not just made by the LSPDFR 0.4 folks, like Albo's callouts, Dark Meyer callouts, etc., so on and so forth, show up in here. That would be really, really nice. But should you update just yet? I would say yes if you have an extra copy of GTA 5 hanging around your hard drive. If not, I'd say hang on, because there isn't, like you said, as you can see here, there's only two calls for LSPDFR 0.4, which are pursuit and hold up. And hold up is a robbery. That's the only call outs you're gonna get, unless you want to keep doing traffic stuff, which is fine. But yes, you can put your custom cars in again. You can put everything else again except the call outs and I would just say, for some of you, if you don't have the best computer, just hang on. I'm putting the graphic mods in there. All right, guys, that's been a tutorial on how to install LSPDFR 0.4, a detailed tutorial installation for this mod. I hope you guys, I hope it helped you out. Like I said, installing it is very simple, but there are a few steps that you should take if you're not running a vanilla copy of GTA 5. If this video helped you out, make sure you help me out by hitting the like button, comment below, and like I said, if you're new to the channel, plenty of quality audio and video on LSPDFR with the most realistic policing that I can possibly give you. Thank you guys very much for watching. My name is Juratastic, and I am